inclusiveness is such a broad topic. It's we need to consider family needs, children needs, economic backgrounds of families, cultural backgrounds, traditions, so many different things when we talk about inclusiveness, that we want to really get an insight into what each family needs so we can be culturally sensitive, sensitive to family backgrounds and things like that. So we're open to a range of different ideas that come from the families and from the community as well, which I think is really important for us to be open. Because what was inclusive for our group 1 year will definitely change the following year. So we really need to get to know our families and know what they want us to bring to our program. So I think our biggest strategy that we use is really getting to know our families and trying to make them feel comfortable. We give them opportunities to join in our activities and our program, and we really want to hear their voice and, you know, want them to offer their skills and pop in and see us and join our group.
Within our foyer area, we have a Wominjee consign to welcome our families. We also have our harmony tree that says all our families' hellos in their different cultures and in their different languages. So immediately families feel connected just walking within our foyer, and they feel connected within the program as well. At the start of the year, we send out getting to know you to our families. We ask questions about what celebrations they might celebrate at home, any special events. With the information that's gathered from families, educators can then embed that information within their programs, and they can cater to the children's needs, interests within the program.
We have some Aboriginal groups coming to our kinder and celebrating with us. We are learning from them as well. We have a rap as well. That's the main thing, I think. So involving our families and working as a team and using the parents' feedback as a positive input.